Hey, what's up everyone? My name is Vivian from the Paper Letter Blog, and today I'm going to create a flipbook swap on camera. There's a little fly buzzing around my camera. I got him. So some of you may know this website called swapbot.com. I joined this a couple months ago, and so far I've only done a lot of goodie swaps or washi tape swaps or even tea swaps. And I haven't really done a lot of these creative swaps, you know, like the ones where you do some crafting. And I am going to create a flipbook for this swap today, and I thought I would show you how I'm going to do that. So I wrote down the swap guidelines. It's a flipbook or a journal, and you're going to base it on the receiver's profile. It has to have at least 4 pages and include a short letter. Then I received my swap partner. I will be sending her this swap, but she will be sending hers to someone else, and then I will receive my swap form another person randomly picked from the group. So I don't know, I didn't really get a lot to work with, but I'm just going to make a cute little flip book with a lot of colors and, you know, some goodies in there, and we will see how that goes. So like usual, with these videos, I'm just going to see what I come up with and create. But yesterday I was playing around with my new scoreboard, and I made this cute little envelope. And I wanted to base my flipbook around that. So I made this little card. See, this is like another little envelope. And then you open it like this, and then the envelope will be either here or there. And I also have these two, which will be on the outside here. So then you have 1, 2, 3, 4, basically, or 5. So I have decided that I will be putting the envelope on the bottom flap. But before I glue that down, I just want to do some decorating on the back. And I think I might use my new paper punch. So I just need to see. Put this down this way so that I can see which papers would match. Oh, I also have my, I always keep my scraps in here, which is very convenient for using paper punches. So if you fast forward, this is how it turned out. I actually really like the way it looks, because I wasn't sure if the colors would match together, but I think it looks really cute, especially with the blue envelope in front. And I love how it is a little bit messy, but still kind of fun and quirky in my opinion. And having to fill an entire blank space can sometimes be a little bit challenging, at least I think so. And I just like doing it like this. Okay, so I just like making sure that there's enough space between the envelope and the folding line, because sometimes it can be a little bit hard to close a flipbook once you're done. Not yet entirely sure how I'm going to decorate the other pages, because a lot of people, when they make flipbooks that I see on Instagram, for example, they mainly do collages. So they would do one pocket or one envelope or two envelopes and then decorate the other pages with collages and blah blah blah. But personally, I'm not that good in making collages, so I'm hoping to create some more pockets. I'm just gonna have to have a think about that, but while I'm doing that, I thought it would be fun to start with making the little paperclip better. I think it's called paperclip better. Another thing that always happens whenever I craft, I let my coffee get cold. Okay, I have decided that I'm not going to add any embellishments or something to this banner because I think it looks cute as it is. I might add some gold tape on the background though. Yes. Got the little banner finished. Okay, so my ideas are slowly flowing in. What I'm going to do is, you saw me create this little bag of stickers and this washi tape sample, and I'm going to decorate these two flaps later, and then I'm going to put the washi tape tag on one and the bag of stickers on the other one. And I also picked out this really cute piece of paper. This is just some letter paper, and that is my cat scratching the couch. I picked this out, and then I'm going to write a little note on here for her. And then I'm going to put this at the top. I'm going to make a collage in the middle here. And then I'm also going to decorate the outsides. So that is what I'm going to be doing. And you're going to watch me do it. So I'm filling up all of my SD cards, so I might need to take a break very soon. So I already filmed this, but then my camera shut off, so I have to do it again. What I said is that the receiver of this swap said that she likes all colors, but she prefers the black or the dark ones. So I'm trying to put in as much dark colors as possible, but I only have these dark blues from the paper pad that I just showed you. Lovely day, my dear Lizzie. So I'm just going to see what I can do with that. Then I measured this out because I want to use this to make a little pocket up here. And then now I'm going to use, this is my scoring board, score and trim. I'm going to score, I think about half a centimeter. So that the pocket gets a little bit easier to open. Just gonna show you what I mean in a second. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply glue to the inside, to this end, this and this. I'm going to apply glue, and then when you put it onto the paper, as you can see, it's a little bit, or at least I hope you can see, it's a little bit, it has a little bit more wiggle room than when you would just put it flat on the paper. So I'm hoping that that will create a nice look and an easy to open pocket. But before I glue it on there, I just want to use one of the paper punches. Again, yes, again. Because I like making a little circle out of the middle so that you can easily take out the letter. Okay, so as predicted, I filled up all of my SD cards. I didn't really do anything, I just punched a hole through the flap, I don't know, with this thing that I have from my sewing kit, and I put some thread through it. Just chose purple because, I don't know, I like purple. And now, oh yeah, what I also did is I just folded up the little letter, and then it goes in the pocket here. And I just think that looks really cute. So I use my Crayola Super Tips to make these little hearts. I really like the cute little look they give. I put some letter stickers here, spelling the word letter, and then I used, what's this called? Fineliner to create these little lines around the envelope and the pocket. This is something that I saw someone do, I think also on YouTube, I'm sorry, I don't remember who it was. I saw someone create like a little line around their work, and I just really like the way it looks, so I'm just sort of experimenting with that. Never draw on these videos, and now you know why. No, I actually think it looks kind of cute. I used my hexagon punch to punch out these hexagons, and I made this sort of beehive thingy, and then I put, I don't know why I did that, but I just made a little pattern with a blue crayon with a blue super tip, I don't know, and then I drew these flowers around, and then I decided to make a little border, and I also did it on this side, and it looks a little bit messy, but I actually quite like that, because when everything is like straight and neat, it doesn't really work for me. Also, this is also quite messy, and I just like the way that looks. So I am going to put the stickers on that side. The glue is white when you apply it, but when it dries, it turns invisible, which is great because I have the gluing skills of a 2-year-old. As you can see, the glue wasn't coming out, and then of course it all came out at once, so had to fix that. But yeah, you're not gonna see anything once it dries. I wanted to say that I just really like the way this looks, because if I would have only done the die cast, I think it would have looked a little bit boring, and on her profile it said that she didn't like plain, so I made sure that it wasn't plain, and now it is sparkly and cute, and I just really like the way it looks. Guys, I told you that it was dark outside, right, all day, and now there's actually thunder. I don't know why, but this always excites me so much. Okay, I'm just gonna finish this. I was gone for a little bit, not that you would know, because I'm just editing this, but my camera is, the battery is really low. I just added this little die cut, golden die cut, don't know if you can see that says smile, and yeah, gonna edit. Oh, and I also wrote my little letter, just wrote some stuff about me and about the swap and about the video that I'm making, and then I hand lettered her name, like, hey Alaya, so when she takes this out it'll look really nice. At least I think so. Oh, my poor cat. I'm actually excited about this thunder and she's scared. Okay, so this is just a tag that I made, just, you know, circle a tag on a piece of paper and then cut it out, and you have a handmade tag. I think it would be cute if I could use this. Just have to see. Do you hear that thunder? There hasn't been thunder for so long. I'm gonna put this either on the front or on the back. I think the back. Yes, let me just put it on the back. You know what? I'm going to put, oh my god, it's actually a little bit scary. Okay, I'm gonna put the twine through the tag to create a nice and finished look. Go back here, and it'll just hold the twine in place, you know. It's all about the details, right? I love it when the details are just right. Anyway, this lace is a little bit like popping up right now, but I know that it will be closed like this for a couple days before it arrives at the receiver, so then it will be probably be nice and flat. What I did, I started with this one. I made this little tag that says please open me, and then I put all of these cute little die cuts from the Maggie Holmes collection that I cut out, and then just some circles that I had left from the envelope. And then I did this side, just simple. I wanted to continue the flower theme, and I put a little, I don't know how you call this, a square basically with a flower and the word grateful. I don't want it to be too much because I'm also going to wrap the twine around it. And then on the inside here, I just did these golden hearts, the word smile. I used these foam stickers behind this die cut to create a nice little effect, and you know, cute little flowers here, and the paper clip that I made. Now I'm just gonna finish this up. So believe it or not, but my battery died again and I didn't notice it in time, so I picked out a lot of die cuts and put them in this little pocket here. But I don't really think you want to see my die cut collection one more time in this video anyway, so that's okay. I just picked out a lot of flowers and stuff because I read that she likes those. And now it's finally done. I'm actually really, really happy with how this turned out. I don't think I've ever made a flipbook this elaborate. Is it called elaborate? I don't think I've ever made a flipbook this big and with this many pages and this many details and stuff. Please help me out here. English is not my first language. But I really love how it turned out. I really like the golden enamel dots. I don't want to use that word ever in a video because I'm never sure if I pronounce it right. Anyway, I love this little pocket for a letter. I really like the way that this envelope and the page turned out. I like these two pages. I like my collage. And then these two collages, you know, they're not that special, but I still think that they look fun. And then this, and she gets one of those little banner paper clips. And then this, and now I'm just going to wrap this up. And then I'm going to decorate the envelope, because that's just what I do. And then I'm going to send it off to the United States. That is all, I guess, for now. So thank you for watching. Bye bye.